That was Paul Bunyan, the biggest and mightiest woodsman who ever lived, cutting down 6 trees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 trees with one blow. Let me tell you, Paul Bunyan was a mighty big man, he was. They say he was 3 mountains high. And he was 3 rivers wide. And there wasn't any problem he couldn't figure out. Yes, sir. He was a big man, he was.
Paul Bunyan was a mighty big man. A mighty big man was he. He swung an axe with his left hand tied, and down would come 6 trees. He was big and strong, lived 100 years long, happy as one could be. Paul Bunyan was a mighty big man. A mighty big man was he.
Now Paul had a faithful friend, a big blue ox that he called Babe. Oh, no, don't let the name fool you, cause Babe was anything but a baby. Babe was the biggest ox that ever was. How big? Well, sir, that's hard to say. Only a few people have ever seen Babe, but one man told me that an eagle used to sit on Babe's right horn, and people would bet how long it would take the eagle to fly across Babe's head to the left horn.
The eagle was big and the eagle was strong, but the trip from the horn was ever so long that the eagle did fly like never before. For 15 hours he struggled and tore. What a trip! What a time! Oh my! He flew and he flew, losing strength all the way, a puffing and a pushing took a whole long day. Still he circled and dived and he puffed and roared, used 6 pair of wings that the wind had torn. What a trip!
What a trip!
What a time!
What a time!
Oh my!
My!
What a trip! What a time! Oh my!
Oh my! Well, that was Babe. You can figure out how big Babe was from that. And how strong, too. Well, now, Paul and Babe were great friends. They would go from forest to forest, helping the timbermen build camps and clear forests and get lumber for all the people to use to build houses with. One day, during the year of the blue snow, that was when the snow melted and became ink. Well, sir, that day, Paul and Babe came to a new logging camp. It was a busy camp. Were really busy cutting wood down, for there were so many people that needed homes, and without the wood they couldn't even start. Why, this camp had cleared 3 forests of timber and had it stacked neat and ready, when all of a sudden... Trouble ahead. The Whistling River, the meanest river in the hills. The water started to rush faster and faster, throwing logs and trees in all directions. All of the work that Paul's friends, the woodsmen, had worked so hard at was scattered and thrown about, wasted. And all of those good people who needed lumber would just have to wait some more. Well, sir, old Paul would have to do something about this. So he ordered his friends to clear a circle 30 miles long, a road, so that he could pace around and around and think this out without hurting anyone. Old Paul was worried what to do. The people needed lumber and this wouldn't do.
Oh, what a problem.
The river was wild with a whistling name. We'll have to fix it and make it tame.
Oh, what a problem. Paul did think more than ever before.
I'll tie it to Babe and stop the roar. What an idea this was. Paul was going to hitch the river to Babe and drag it into a new place where it could roar all it wanted to and not hurt anyone. Boy, oh boy! He would hitch up Babe to the river and pull it clean across the country to open land. Maybe even to a desert, because they could use water out there. So Paul got all of the men busy to build a chain 17 miles long for Babe's harness.
Bend that steel for Babe to use. She'll move the river and no more blues.
The men worked and worked all that day and all the next day. 2,000 men to make the biggest chain ever built. A chain 17 miles long. finally, it was done. The chain was ready for Babe. So off to the river they all went to watch the greatest feat of the age. But when they got to the river, they discovered there was no way to tie the chain to the water. And how right it was. How could you tie a chain to water? Well, now Paul really got angry. And he became angrier by the minute. This time, old Paul really had a problem to think out. After all, these people were depending upon him to tame the wild, whistling river. So, he ordered the men to clear a circle 60 miles round.
Let's make a circle 60 miles round, so Paul can find an idea that's sound. Chop, 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 chop. Clear that timber, knock down the pine. Hurry, 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 cause we haven't got time. Chop, 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 chop.
Well, it took 2,000 men only a short while to clear the path for Paul to pace in and think. So Paul began his pacing.
He'll fix that river once and for all.
I'll stop that roaring like a wild waterfall.
Oh, what a problem.
The river wrecked lumber, no work is done. I can't stop now till the battle is won.
Oh, what a problem. Paul's blue eyes got a sudden gleam.
I'll build a fire, turn the river to steam. And that's a better idea. So that was to be Paul's solution. He was going to build a big fire from one end of the river to the other, and that would turn it to steam. Get all the lumber around the river! What activity! Men for hundreds of miles around were collecting lumber and putting it alongside the river for the mightiest fire the world has ever seen. And finally, it was all ready. On either side of the river, for 100 miles long, lumber was stacked in bonfire piles. And now it was time to start the experiment going. Light the fires! Light the fires! And as far as the eye could see, fires were started. What a sight this was! 20,000 bonfires all going at the same time! And slowly, but surely, the heat started to reach the wild, whistling river. And the river was bucking and getting wilder with the boiling caused by the heat. And as the steam started to rise, Paul's plan looked like it would work out all right. But when the steam started to rise and it reached the cold air, it turned to rain. And the rain made the fires go out. Well, when this time Paul's plan didn't work, he was really on the rampage. He couldn't let this wild river beat him. So he cleared a circle 90 miles round. And he paced and he paced and he roared and he roared and he fumed and he fumed and he puffed and he puffed. And what do you think happened? His puffing started a hurricane blowing that moved the clouds out of the sky and brought about a cold wind. A wind so cold that it started to freeze everything. Why, it became so cold that the river froze. That was it. That was the solution. He could tie the chain to the ice, and then Babe could pull it away. Get the chain set. Paul bellowed so loud that men 17 miles away could hear him. Oh, what activity. What wonderful things were happening. This was a feat that had never been done before. And now everyone was ready. Paul tied the chain to Babe's harness. Come on, Babe. Come on, Babe. Oh, how Babe strained. Babe, the blue ox was getting red with straining. Come on, Babe. Come on, pull. Oh, how Babe was trying. She kicked up 30 acres of soil in the pull, creating a canyon. The ice is giving. Oh, just a little bit more. Come on, Babe. He did it! The river is moving! Old Paul did it!
Paul Bunyan was a mighty big man. A mighty big man was he. He moved a river that was mean and long so his friends could all be free. He is kind and good, builds brotherhood, works for democracy. Paul Bunyan was a mighty big man was he.